American Energy and you, together partnering to change the energy landscape by pioneering money-saving, energy efficiency programs and building a new industry in Iowa, wind energy, all while keeping your rates low. So what's next? We'll keep delivering cost-effective energy efficiency programs while putting money back in your pocket. That's right. You decide how best to spend your savings. That's a partnership good for you, good for the environment, and good for Iowa. Another way we're obsessively, relentlessly at your service.
Here's to everyone who believes in competition and good sportsmanship, who knows it's not about the trophies or the medals, but rather the lessons learned. For those who understand, it's not whether you win or lose, just that you give your best. So go ahead, lace them up, take the field, have fun, and play. For the experience, for the memories, for the love of the game, Shields.
Hi, Ron here, head coach of Westside Auto Pros. When your car's on the injured reserve, you want to get it back in the game as soon as possible. I know that. That's why you need to bring it here to Westside Auto Pros. I have a team of experts that can fix almost every automotive injury, whether it's a fractured joint, a brake, or if your car just got its bell rung, no problem. We can even do a complete physical on your car to make sure it's game ready for the entire season. So bring your car to Westside Auto Pros and we'll get it back in the starting lineup in no time. Hey, you guys are dogging it back here. Let's move it, move it, move it.
You want to get stronger, faster, healthier. You want more. You want to be part of something bigger than yourself. A place for people of all ages, all walks of life, that provides opportunities for all to succeed. We do that. We're the why. Build more than muscle. Build a stronger community.
We are live from Thunderhead Sports Bar and Grill in Ankeny on Oil Labor. I'm Jimmy Olson at CISN.TV this week. And joining me is Jackie Sapp. And we've got a great show coming up tonight, a great play of the week that you're going to see, as well as a video of the week that we're going to share with you. And then, Jackie, you've got a great interview that's coming up a little bit later, too, in the show.
Yes, I do. I have a segment called Face Behind the Scene. And we're going to find out a little bit more about Coach Tracy Daly from Southeast Polk, where she came from, how she got to where she is today, and I'm anxious to hear what she's got to say.
That'll be fantastic. Of course, Dar Danielson, he's on vacation this week, but we do have an interview from him that he had earlier this season with Brenda, that's Freese, right?
Yes,
yeah,
Freese.
He actually got to catch up with her, and she was just in the paper this weekend, coming up on her 500th win. Victory.
That's correct.
And so we're going to share that with you. That's all coming up. CISN.TV this week. So you'll be able to check that out tonight. Again, I'm Jimmy Olson with Jackie Sapp. And let's go ahead and get things started. Let's kind of like that week in review. What are we looking at with boys basketball right now?
Well, since the break, this is what the standings are for the CML. I've got a breakdown for the Central Division, Iowa Division, and the Metro Division. Central Division, Johnston's leading the division. They did get knocked off last Friday night by Ankeny Centennial. And then the Iowa Division, Waukee, perfect record. They're number one in the state, so they're rolling just like they should be. The closest game they had was against Valley back in December, where they won by 1.49-48. And then in the Metro Division is North, who's 5-0.
There's
in the
my polar bears
there
right there. Come
yep.
on.
They're rocking and rolling.
Like they always do. I always have the story when I remember, because when I went to high school at North High, and, of course, our football team is, well, it's our football team. It is what it is. But our basketball team always did well, and I remember when we made it to state. And, of course, the day that they were going to play at Vets, we got the day off of school because they figured everybody would be jipping anyway. So we got the afternoon off so we could go down and watch the game.
Did you go?
No, I went home.
And now you're talking sports.
Exactly.
All right. Their upcoming game is against Lincoln on the 11th, and then they play Ottumwa on the 18th. So in terms of the state standings, which when I look for them, this is as of December 21st. We got Waukee, number one in the state in Class 4A, North Scott, Ankeny 3, Davenport Central 4, Iowa City 5, Bettendorf 6, Sioux City East 7th, Valley is 8th, Cedar Falls 9th, and then to round off the top 10 is Prairie, Cedar Rapids.
And, of course, we'll be looking at those a little bit later as well so they can see those standings with the boys and with the girls. That's a great way to get us into the girls' side. How are our girls looking after the break?
I tell you, at the start of the break, there was a few key losses, but and there was one Friday night. Johnston got beat by Ankeny Centennial by 2 points, which there are video of the of the night. They're sitting 4-1 in the Central, and then the Iowa division is Southeast Polk with a perfect record in the division. They only have one loss for the season. That was against Dowling. And then in the Metro Division, Roosevelt's leading the league. And some key games, Mason City at Roosevelt on the 15th. And then for the Iowa Division, a key game is Southeast Polk Valley, which we're doing on Friday night.
That's right,
CISN.
Yeah. Two shows that you can catch right here on CISN.TV Friday night. Centennial at Ankeny, both the boys and the girls. And then also Friday night, Southeast Polk and Valley. Again, both of those you can catch right here on CISN.TV.
And then just have the 5A standings, and those haven't changed because they came out the 20th, and they haven't revised those since the beginning of the year. And I'll just say the Metro Schools, Johnson's number 2, Southeast Polk is 4, Waukee's 5, Valley's 6, Dowling Catholic's 9, and Ankeny Centennial 12, Ames 13. So I'm sure that that will probably shake up since Johnston got beat last Friday night.
I'm sure it will. So we'll be looking forward to what those rankings look like. You know, of course, when we come back on next week. First show after the new year. So we want to say Happy New Year to everyone. Hopefully everyone had a great holiday, great Christmas, a great New Year. And as we kind of get into 2019, steaming ahead.
And hopefully it's a good one.
It always is, right? what's ever bad?
Well, if you're a coach, there's probably a lot of bad things. You know, if you're not a coach, it probably doesn't matter.
We can always come up with something.
That's
true. What's that list, right? So still a lot of great stuff to come tonight on this week on CISN.TV. In fact, we'll be having the play of the week and the video of the week. We'll be doing that with Flynn Heald. He'll be joining me here in just a few minutes on CISN.TV, live from the Thunderhead Sports Bar and Grill on Ora Labor in Ankeny. For Jackie Sapp, I'm Jimmy Olson.
Is this guy a contractor who does good work or a contractor who needs work? For a reliable recommendation, trust the Better Business Bureau, protecting consumers for over a century. When you go to BBB.org to check out a business, you'll learn if it's BBB accredited, see its grade on customer service, and read honest, useful reviews from local people. For online recommendations you can trust, start with trust at BBB.org/Iowa.
Miss your hometown clothing store? The one that had it all? Everything to get the work done all in one place? G&L Clothing is your hometown Iowa store. Stop in and see us, or we're only a click or phone call away. Family owned for nearly a century, G&L Clothing, 1801 Ingersoll, Des Moines.
G&L Clothing, your size, your style, we've got it all.
Moms typically get to make a majority of the healthcare decisions for their family. That can be a lot of pressure. But not for me, because I know the choice is ours. For medical tests like MRIs, x-rays, CAT scans, and of course mammograms, ask your doctor to refer you to Iowa Radiology. They work around our hectic schedules, they're the best at what they do, and they're so great with my family. They truly care, and it shows. Visit iowaradiology.com or call to schedule an appointment. Iowa Radiology, our focus is your good health.
The year-end holiday tag event at Schottenkirk Ford, Indianola. All vehicles are tagged with one low price. New bonus tagged 18 Ford F-150s up to $14,000 off MSRP. Your choice. Up to $8,500 off MSRP. New 18 Ford Explorer and new 18 Ford Edge. Year-end tag event in Indianola. Including thousands under retail value on Schottenkirk certified pre-owned vehicles. Hurry in for best selection. Schottenkirk Ford, Indianola. SchottenkirkFord.com.
From Thunderhead Sports Bar and Grill in Ankeny on Ora Labor, I'm Jimmy Olson. It's CISN.TV this week, and joining me right now is Flynn Heald, and we're getting ready for that play of the week, which don't forget, you can always share your plays of the week with us. You can do that on Twitter. You can do that also on Facebook and share those with us. And you never know, it could be your play of the week, which it just happens to be our play of the week. Is our play of the week. So it's courtesy of CISN.TV.
Yep, that is right. Courtesy of CISN.TV. And like always, we got ourselves a nice highlight coming to you from the girls' Centennial versus Johnston game. Here we go.
Paul has all the commentary.
Just that time, 5 seconds. 3, 2, Sauer throws it. And it's good!
Oh, my Lord!
Nothing but net.
Hey, we need a rerun on that one.
Oh, my goodness.
It's one of those that they say you had to be there to see it, and we were.
Yep, we were. That's exactly right.
So now we've got our video of the week. What's the video, Flynn?
The video of the week is going to come to us from the Southeast Polk girls basketball game.
All right, Flynn, and how can they get those plays of the week to us?
You can go ahead and share us with those on Facebook or Twitter at CISN.TV.
That's right. Get it to us. It could be your play of the week that you're going to see right here this week on CISN.TV. Hang on. Jackie is going to be talking with the girls' head basketball coach from Southeast Polk. That's coming up next, live right here from Thunderhead Sports Bar and Grill in Ankeny on Oral Labor. I'm Jimmy Olson for Flynn Heald on CISN.TV this week.
Energy and you, together partnering to change the energy landscape by pioneering money-saving, energy efficiency programs and building a new industry in Iowa, wind energy, all while keeping your rates low. So what's next? We'll keep delivering cost-effective energy efficiency programs while putting money back in your pocket. That's right, you decide how best to spend your savings. That's a partnership good for you, good for the environment, and good for Iowa. Another way we're obsessively, relentlessly at your service.
Mid-American Energy believes in competition and good sportsmanship, who knows it's not about the trophies or the medals, but rather the lessons learned. For those who understand, it's not whether you win or lose, just that you give your best. So go ahead, lace them up, take the field, have fun, and play. For the experience, for the memories, for the love of the game, Shields.
Stronger, faster, healthier. You want more. You want to be part of something bigger than yourself. A place for people of all ages, all walks of life, that provides opportunities for all to succeed. We do that. We're the why. Build more than muscle. Build a stronger community.
Ron here, head coach of Westside Auto Pros. When your car's on the injured reserve, you want to get it back in the game as soon as possible. I know that. That's why you need to bring it here to Westside Auto Pros. I have a team of experts that can fix almost every automotive injury, whether it's a fractured joint, a brake, or if your car just got its bell rung, no problem. We can even do a complete physical on your car to make sure it's game ready for the entire season. So bring your car to Westside Auto Pros and we'll get it back in the starting lineup in no time.
It's better if they can't.
Hey, you guys are dogging it back here. Let's move it, move it, move it.
Hi.
We're starting a new segment tonight, and it's called Face Behind the Scene. And the purpose of Face Behind the Scene is to take a look at different aspects of girls' athletics here in Iowa. And so our first guest is going to be Coach Tracy Daly, the head coach at Southeast Polk. And I'm sure people aren't really probably aware of her background because she's not an Iowa-grown girl. She is from the show-me state, and she's definitely shown us a few things about her abilities as a coach. She's also was a first-team All-Stater her junior and senior year in high school. Her team got second state her senior year. She went on to a community college, was an All-American there. Then she went on to a Division I school where she was newcomer of the year. And then she started her coaching trail. So I'm just going to have Tracy tell you a little bit about her background and her journey to how she got to Southeast Polk.
Wow. Okay. Background, like you said, I was born in Missouri. After college, it was kind of one of those life-changing moments of the final buzzer sounds and you don't really know what to do next. And I knew I didn't want to leave the game, but I hadn't really prepared myself academically to continue coaching in education. So I taught at a private school for a couple years and then moved back to Missouri. And my husband always makes fun of me and says I'm a dabbler when it comes to occupations, but the one thing that's always stuck is I've always coached, whether I was a crime scene analyst for the Missouri State Highway Patrol, or a photographer, stay-at-home mom. The one thing that was always consistent was that I wanted to coach and coach basketball for the past probably, 25 years, I guess. And then kids and family and jobs moved us back to Iowa, and then we wanted to relocate to a little bit bigger town. We kind of knew eventually when our kids got into school, we wanted to move to an Iowa City, Des Moines type town just to give them more opportunities. And then the job just kind of opened up and fell into my lap, and it's been great ever since.
Well, and also I think this is what's interesting about you is when you started out at parochial school. Were you coaching high school or junior high?
High school, yeah.
High school. Then you come back to Missouri. And you're coaching high school, your high school you graduated from, which was Jefferson City.
Right.
And then she goes to a collegiate job, which was Westminster. I mean, it's a smaller school, but still it's a college job. Then she moves to Iowa, and what do you start coaching then?
Junior high.
So you've really done the whole
gamut.
Done it all.
Which, honestly, though, I think in my present job, I think that's one of the reasons why we're so committed to our youth program at Southeast Polk. You know, when we think of program, I think 3rd through 12th. I don't just think 9 through 12 or just think varsity. So we're really involved in what we do with our 3rd, 4th, 5th, all the way up through 12th grade. And I think that's probably part of the reason why.
Okay, then in 2012 is when you take the Southeast Polk job.
No pressure there, yes.
And there was no talent, right?
No. Yeah, preseason number one, first day on the job, that was a little rough. But.
And she wins a state title, and she's also named Coach of the Year that year. Okay, from that point to where you're at now, what kind of roller coaster, what's it been like in terms of your program?
There's been some changes here and there. I have a great coaching staff. We've been consistent over the past 7 years. I think we've, talent comes and goes. But I think, like I said, being so involved in our youth program, I think consistently we can compete with the best teams in the state, whether we have five D1 players on the floor or we have no D1 players on the floor. And I think, there's a lot of emphasis put on that these days. But I think just going back old school and focusing on playing like a team and team chemistry and sharing the ball, I think that's kind of what's kept us, one of the top teams in the state.
Whatever made you decide to get into coaching? Who was inspirational in your life?
My high school coach had a big impact. He was kind of like, he was like a second father to me. He had a big impact, just the relationships that he built. And I think just when you're finished playing and you realize what the game gave to you, and it's kind of like you feel like you owe the game something, and you feel like you owe the game a little bit, and you need to give back and kind of show others and show the next generation what it did for you and kind of help them along the way.
So had you ever had a female coach as a coach when throughout your playing years?
I did. In college, I had, at the University of New Mexico, my junior year, we had a female, all-female staff.
So, going in, and are you the first female coach that Southeast Polk's ever had? I kind of think maybe you might be.
Head coach, yes.
Yes, head coach. So, how do you think that plays in terms of relationships with players? Do you think there's a difference between having a female coach and a male coach in terms of,
I think relationship-wise, it's probably the difference between having a dad and a mom. I think there's a lot of similarities, but I think that, there are a lot of things that are the same. I definitely think you can coach boys and girls. I always hear that you can't coach girls the same as boys. I definitely disagree with that statement, but I think that there are differences But I think as long as you have a nurturing role as a man or a woman, I think it's a successful relationship.
Okay, we'll be right back with Tracy with a few more questions.
Moms typically get to make a majority of the healthcare.
Okay, real quick, what are I gonna say?
That can be a lot of pressure, but not for me, because I know the choice is ours. For medical tests like MRIs, x-rays, CAT scans, and of course mammograms, ask your doctor to refer you to Iowa Radiology. They work around our hectic schedules, they're the best at what they do, and they're so great with my family. They truly care, and it shows. Visit iowaradiology.com or call to schedule an appointment. Iowa Radiology, our focus is your good health.
Your hometown clothing store, the one that had it all, everything to get the work done, all in one place. G&L Clothing is your hometown Iowa store. Stop in and see us, or we're only a click or phone call away. Family owned for nearly a century, G&L Clothing, 1801 Ingersoll, Des Moines.
Okay, we're back with Coach Daly, and let's talk a little bit about, you know, what running your program. I was fortunate enough, and I feel very privileged that I had a chance to come out to your practice and got to see how it was run, and it was very efficient. What are some ground rules? Do you have any specific, like, a rule that maybe you know, that instills team that you have with your players, or
sure,
you just kind of go with flow?
No, I definitely don't go with the flow. I think I'm a bit of a control freak in terms of certain things. But I think the biggest thing that we focus on is respect. And we don't announce it, we don't say it a lot, but it's just kind of the culture in which we do our stuff. There's kind of a draw to running as much because we trust that the kids understand the game because they're learning it and they've been through the system and, you know, and they know. Now, the frustrating part is when you have games like maybe like a last night game where things are a little flat, there's not as much that you can do on the sidelines because it's more of their energy level and them doing what they know that they can do, but you're just having one of those nights. But yeah, I would say just teaching them the game of basketball and knowing that there's no ceiling for girls basketball and they can kind of do whatever.
So they can be thinkers on their own.
Absolutely.
Absolutely. Being the thinker for them.
Well, and I hear a lot that they say that our teams are good passers.
Yes.
I'm like, well, it's not just because we pass well. It's because that's how we've learned the game, and they see that pass right. Because they're used to making it, and it's second nature now. They don't have to think about it.
And, I think that's a tribute to what I saw in practice and how efficient you are in practice and how things move just like that. I mean, I was totally impressed, and I've been to all different levels of practice from – you know, junior high to the collegiate level. So I think that's awesome that you do that. Let's get to the coaching part of it. If you had someone that came to you and said, I want to go into coaching, that was a young female, and I guess I'm focusing on that because we're both females, we both,
sure.
You coach, I used to coach, what would you say to that person? And I think that what impresses me the most is that you've been able to coach, you have a family, you've done a lot of things, and lots of times that's why females get out of coaching,
sure.
Because of the family part of it. So
right.
What would you say to that young person?
First and foremost, good luck. No, I think it's been super fulfilling for me, and I couldn't do it without. I have a very, very supportive family. I have two great kids that are very self-sufficient and basically feed themselves for 5 months out of the year because I don't cook during basketball season. I have a husband who will change diapers and make meals and run kids so I can do what I love to do. We've kind of traded. He was a football coach, and then now I'm a basketball coach. But I think just having a good support system is huge. And then allowing me to do what I love to do makes a big difference. But there's going to be challenges. You know, they always have the female to male, what's it like being a female? And I just always think everything's a challenge, whether you're a female or a male. And if you see a challenge, face it and don't focus on, you know,
the gender,
what they tell you can't do. Just go do
just
it.
Just go do it.
Yeah.
Okay, let's round this off with your flat last night. 1-5. You have a huge game, not to remind you of that.
Right.
But you have a huge game coming up this Friday against Valley. What are some things that go through your mind between now and Friday in terms of your kids being ready? What do you need to do to prepare your kids? Is that something they just need to do on their own? How do you feel about that?
Right. I think everything goes through a coach's mind when they have a big game 48 hours away. But our kids will be ready. I think, or they won't. I mean, it's. I don't know. I think as I get older, I'm a little bit more laid back about, like, it's their season. And we talked about this today at practice. We were a little flat at practice too when we started. You know, it's their season. What do they want out of it? And they can have whatever they want. They just have to work for it because they're good enough and they're talented enough. But so is, you know, the next team down the road, and so is the next four teams down the road, especially in the CIML. It's a stacked conference like it is every year, and you have to bring your A game every day. And if you practice at 70%, you're going to show 70% in a game. So you really have to step it up and find the next level and find your ceiling and then break through it and find the next ceiling. So you're just focusing on getting better and trying to get through the lull of mid-January.
And that's, you know, if you're going to have some hiccups, now's the time to have them because you want to have the momentum going into the tournament.
Right.
So,
yep.
I want to thank you.
Yeah.
And I do want to say this about Coach Daly. She is a class act, and she does have the right approach because I can remember when you were ranked number one, it's kind of the kiss of death, and you kind of said that. I mean, you know,
right.
If you're going to expect to stay undefeated, that puts a lot of pressure on you and your kids. So I think you have everything in perspective, and I think that for the young coaches out there, whether you're male, female, otherwise, you're a definite person that they should watch and model themselves after because you have some good things to offer.
Aw, thank you.
And thank you for being our guest tonight.
You bet.
Hi, Ron here, head coach of Westside Auto Pros. When your car's on the injured reserve, you want to get it back in the game as soon as possible. I know that. That's why you need to bring it here to Westside Auto Pros. I have a team of experts that can fix almost every automotive injury, whether it's a fractured joint, a brake, or if your car just got its bell rung, no problem. We can even do a complete physical on your car to make sure it's game ready for the entire season. So bring your car to Westside Auto Pros and we'll get it back in the starting lineup in no time. Hey, you guys are dogging it back here. Let's move it.
Stronger. Faster. Healthier. You want more. You want to be part of something bigger than yourself. A place for people of all ages, all walks of life, that provides opportunities for all to succeed. We do that. We're the why. Build more than muscle. Build a stronger community.
Together, partnering to change the energy landscape by pioneering money-saving, energy efficiency programs and building a new industry in Iowa, wind energy, all while keeping your rates low. So what's next? We'll keep delivering cost-effective energy efficiency programs while putting money back in your pocket. That's right. You decide how best to spend your savings. That's a partnership good for you, good for the environment, and good for Iowa. Another way we're obsessively, relentlessly at your service.
Miss your hometown clothing store? The one that had it all, everything to get the work done, all in one place. G&L Clothing is your hometown Iowa store. Stop in and see us, or we're only a click or phone call away. Family owned for nearly a century, G&L Clothing, 1801 Ingersoll, Des Moines.
G&L Clothing, your size, your style, we've got it all.
Is this guy a contractor who does good work? Or a contractor who needs work. For a reliable recommendation, trust the Better Business Bureau, protecting consumers for over a century. When you go to BBB.org to check out a business, you'll learn if it's BBB accredited, see its grade on customer service, and read honest, useful reviews from local people. For online recommendations you can trust, start with trust at BBB.org/Iowa.
Welcome back to CISN.TV. Today we have a conversation with Bo Lombardi. Bo is a little accolades about Bo Lombardi. Bo's a three-year varsity football player. One is a tight end. Two is a quarterback at Valley High School. A four-year varsity wrestler. Currently the number one rated wrestler in the state at 285 pounds. You are involved in show choir and an honor roll student. Bo, how you doing, bud?
Good. How are you doing, Flynn?
I'm doing awesome. So a little background on Bo and I. Bo and I have known each other for quite some time. His father was my football coach, so you know, it's just like two friends up here chatting it up. So, you know, obviously I know you started out the season unhealthy. The ankle was bothering you, you had some injuries. Kind of talk to the people about, you know, what that was like going through that at the beginning of the season and, you know, what it's taken to get to where you're at now.
For sure. You know, wrestling's such a tough guy sport, and we have some awesome coaches on our staff. We got a couple of guys that were Division I All-Americans. Then our head coach is actually a three-time national champ at Simpson. I mean, we got a lot of tough guys on our staff. So right away I came in with an ankle injury, but, you know, they got workouts for that. They got workouts for everything. So right away they put me on an Aerodyne bike. I'm in there biking every day. They still got me on an upper body plan, and and that sort of stuff for wrestling. So I wasn't, I was out maybe a couple days, maybe a week, and then right back into the room.
So what did you feel like the hardest part was to get back? Was it the strength, the conditioning? You know, what was it?
For sure in wrestling, I think it's conditioning. Conditioning is a huge part of the sport. You know, it's a long match, and the whole match, you're trying to out-muscle the guy. You're always trying to get a leg up in position, so there's never a time to rest. It's not a five-second burst with a 25-second play clock. You know, the whole match, you're going, and I think for sure the conditioning is the hardest part.
Yeah, so, and Tinsley Wright was another guy who started the season out like you on the sideline. He's now 2-0 at 160. A guy like Tinsley as well, who's fought his way back. You know, what do you have to say about Tinsley as a wrestler and how he's progressed as well coming back from that injury?
I've known Tinsley for a while. He was on my football team back in 7th grade. And a thing I can tell you about Tinsley, he's a fighter, you know. So growing up, he used to not be a very big kid, and he always wanted to compete. He always wanted to play. So he found his way on our football team as a kicker, is now an awesome kicker for us. But on top of that, like I said, he's just an excellent competitor. So this year he missed our first half of the season. We had a really big duel against Waukee. Really came down to just a handful of matches and some bonus points. And he had a big, big win for us early off almost no practice. So, man's just a competitor. So
he absolutely is. He absolutely is. So you obviously didn't start the season ranked at all. You wrestled your way all the way up to the number one spot. You obviously are maintaining a high level of performance right now. What's it going to take to continue that performance all the way through the season into the postseason?
I think one thing that I got going for me compared to most heavyweights is I'm typically a little bit faster. I work a lot with Level Up through Ironworks Gym, kind of increase my speed and stuff. So I think if I can keep my speed up, keep my stamina up, usually I'm in a little bit better shape. I'm only about 240 pounds, so typically I have a little bit better gas tank than some of those guys. But like I said, I can't say enough about our coaching staff. We got a tremendous coaching staff at Valley. They're all wonderful technicians. They get what it is to be a champion. They get what it is to improve a wrestler. So if I follow their lead, kind of take after them as well, I'm going to have a great year.
So did I just hear you say 240 pounds?
Yeah.
240 pounds. That's awesome, man. I've known you for a long time, and I've seen you grow a lot since 240. So, you know, being a 240, you're wrestling 285. Did you think that you had more of an advantage moving up than you did of trying to make that weight cut back down? What is that, 15 pounds?
So, pretty much. But really what it came down to was that at the beginning of the year, I had the option to go down, but our heavyweight didn't come back out this year, so we had no heavyweight. And to be honest with you, I was lifting at about 235, and that's just kind of where I walk around comfortable, and I know that's where I can gain the most strength. So I fought for a while to kind of try to come down, and I just didn't really like it. And I was like, you know what, I'll give it a shot here at 285. I knew our second meet of the year was against the number one ranked heavyweight. So, you know, I went out there just to kind of see where I'd hang with them. Ended up getting a second period fall. And kind of from that point on, I thought, you know what, I'm going to be a very competitive heavyweight. And I knew with our coaching staff I'd be tough to beat. So at that point, I just kind of decided, you know what, maybe 285 is the move for me. So.
Yeah. Well, best of luck to you through the rest of the wrestling season. I'm looking forward to seeing what you do on the mat. You know I'll be there to watch you. You're a senior, progressing into now that closing stage. We're getting ready to get into the end of recruiting, mm-hmm. figuring out where you're going to go to school next year. I know you. You're an athlete. You're a competitor. You've expressed interest in playing at the next level, and I'm not going to corner you and say wrestling or football specifically, but, you know, coaches out there, what I know you. What is something that you think they need to know about Bo Lombardi now through this recruiting process, if they haven't known this already?
Yeah, you know what? I would just say that I think during this wrestling season, I've proven that, you know what, I'm a competitor, and I can do stuff at multiple different positions. You know, wrestling kind of gives me a leg up because I'm moving around these 285-pound guys. I've beaten a handful of All-State O-linemen, D-linemen. So I think it just goes to show that, you know, I'm a competitor. I can move positions. But I know you said you wouldn't corner me wrestling or football, but you know what? I'm a football player. That's what I love to do. My dad's a football coach. My uncle's a football coach. My grandpa's a football coach. My older brother plays football and in college. So it's just what I love to do, and it's what I'm gonna do. So I think proving myself this year at 285 kind of shows colleges that I can move positions, play different positions, and so I think I should have a good year.
I agree entirely, and that's leading right into my next question is, you know, I've seen you play a different position before. I've seen what you're capable of doing both on the football field and on a wrestling mat. I know your athleticism will transition. You've played tight end before. You've played quarterback. Is that something you consider making the transition? Is that a way you're selling yourself as say, hey, I'm not necessarily stuck on being a quarterback. I'm an athlete. I can play multiple positions for you.
Yeah. So kind of the way I look at it is, I for sure believe that I can play quarterback at the next level. But if I commit to a college and you know what they need a center, they need a D tackle, whatever they need, you know what, I can move positions. I can fill that spot. I'm just kind of a versatile guy. I'm a little bit different than most quarterbacks in my versatility, though. Usually when you get a quarterback, you're looking, okay, maybe he can move to wideout, maybe he can move to safety, maybe he can move to, you know, those type of positions. I'm more of a guy where, I mean, I'm a big kid. You're going to want to move me to fullback, to D-tackle, to DN, to inside backer, you know. So, I mean, yeah, I think I can play quarterback, but I also think there's a handful of other positions that I could play and I would earn the job and earn a spot on their team.
I think that'll open more opportunities for you moving forward. So I appreciate the honesty. So, you know, best of luck to you moving forward. What is that ideal situation? You know, if you had to say one situation be perfect, what would it be? I know your brother's up at Michigan State, so I don't know if that means anything. But what would it be? Your most ideal situation?
Most ideal situation, you know, end up in a pro style offense where I can continue to play quarterback. You know. I had a pretty decent year at quarterback, and really it was only my second year playing quarterback. My older brother, Rocky, I always wanted to be on his team. My dad always coached his team, so I've always played with him, but I've always played D-end. I've always played fullback. I've played kind of wherever I can get on the field, you know, just to help the team. So really my first year only playing quarterback was my junior season. It was a pretty good year for us. I think we ended up 8-2 that year. And then my senior year, I ended up an All-State quarterback, really only on my second year ever playing quarterback. So I think I have a lot of potential to grow as a quarterback. So I think if I could end up in a pro-style offense, maybe a Michigan State or an Iowa or Wisconsin, you know, I think I could do a lot of great things for a football team at quarterback.
Yeah, I agree. Well, you know, your film speaks for itself. So you come from a family of coaches, like you said. Your father coach, your grandfather coach, your uncle's a coach up in Minnesota, correct?
Yep. Mm-hmm.
Your mom's a coach as well. How do you think that's given you an advantage as an athlete growing up in a family where the expectation is, you know, it's very detailed?
Yeah. So I've heard the expression before, you know, I grew up in a gym. But I think for my family, I mean, Rocky and I literally grew up in a gym. As soon as we could, I mean, 2, 3, 4 years old, my mom had us in the corner of the volleyball gym shagging balls for him, and my dad had us out on the football team. We're the ball boys since I was maybe 5 or 6. So I think having coaches as parents allowed me to get involved in a lot of things early, kind of make my skill set a little bit more diverse, and it also, having parents as coaches, also taught me a lot about leadership, more essential skills to becoming a better athlete, a better competitor, and that sort of thing.
All right, Bo, we'll go ahead and we'll finish it up and wrap it up right there. Last thing I got for you is a speed round of questions, okay? I'll give you 5 of them, all right? Are you ready for it? First thing that comes to your mind, okay? Your favorite professional athlete?
Tom Brady.
Favorite sports drink?
Sports drink?
Favorite sports drink?
What's this? Oh, Gatorade. I got you.
Okay.
What's a sports drink?
You have to think about it for a sec. One word to describe your football game.
Competitive.
And then last one, who would win in a wrestling match, you or Rocky?
Me.
Okay, that's all with Bo Lombardi here on CISN.TV. Coming up next, we'll have Javier with this week's Talk of the Week.
In competition and good sportsmanship, who knows it's not about the trophies or the medals, but rather the lessons learned. For those who understand, it's not whether you win or lose, just that you give your best. So go ahead, lace them up,
take the field, have fun, and play. For the experience, for the memories, for the love of the game, Shields.
Get stronger, faster, healthier. You want more. You want to be part of something bigger than yourself. A place for people of all ages, all walks of life, that provides opportunities for all to succeed. We do that. We're the why. Build more than muscle. Build a stronger community.
Mid-American Energy and you, together partnering to change the energy landscape by pioneering money-saving, energy efficiency programs and building a new industry in Iowa, wind energy, all while keeping your rates low. So what's next? We'll keep delivering cost-effective energy efficiency programs while putting money back in your pocket. That's right. You decide how best to spend your savings. That's a partnership good for you, good for the environment, and good for Iowa. Another way we're obsessively, relentlessly at your service.
Welcome back, CISN TV. It's Javier here with your TST 20 Fit Tip of the Week with our friend Brad from Beefcake Fuel. Brad, I'm going to talk to you about a couple of things first. But first of all, I want to say it's awesome having another business owner from Iowa in the building.
Love it.
And right now we have a kind of an epidemic going on here in Iowa where we're trying to get people fit and active. So I want to talk to you about Beefcake Fuel and what you guys are doing with the fuel to prep food
absolutely
for people here in Iowa.
Yeah, it's kind of a tongue twister when you say it like that, but that's how we planned it. So our company, Beefcake Fuel, we're located at 28th and University in West Des Moines, Clock Tower Square.
Yep.
It's our restaurant. We've had the restaurant there for a little over a year now. We've actually been in business providing healthy prep meals for over 5 years.
So you guys started off in a food truck,
correct,
right?
Yep, we started off with a food trailer. It sat in our driveway. People would order their meals from our website, beefcakefuel.com. And we used to have a delivery service where refrigerator trucks and we'd drop it off. And a little bit of 1950s milkman, a little bit of Amazon.com, healthy meals, and you didn't have to do anything but type some things on the keyboard.
So did you guys start that here in Des Moines? But because I know you're from Winterset, Iowa.
Yep.
So where did you guys start this?
So we started off, our house, we're in Waukee.
Okay.
So our kids go to school. That's where Cassie and I live. And the trailer really sat just in our driveway. It was the best way to get a kitchen up and going and to see how the healthy meal market was going to work here in Iowa, central Iowa, because there really wasn't anybody doing that
at the time
when we started. We were kind of pioneers in the field. Yeah, yep. Absolutely.
Okay, so I just want to get right to the heart base of it. Yeah. I know you guys make all your food fresh. So if I walk into you and I have my family with me, because I know I'm busy and my son is a wrestler, and you know, we'll talk about wrestling here in a second.
Absolutely.
I want you to tell us how your product can benefit my family, help my kiddo out who's an athlete, just to stay on track with healthy eating.
Yeah. One thing that we say, and it's kind of been our tagline for the longest time, is that eating healthy shouldn't be boring.
Yes.
A lot of people, I think that's part of the obesity epidemic, yep, is that people think grilled chicken and broccoli, that's all I can have. It's not true. We actually, there's not a niche of healthy eating that we can't fill. We've got the prep meals, which we've been doing for a long time. We have the live service restaurant as well, too.
Okay.
So you can walk in and order wraps, flatbreads, things off of our wood fire grill.
So basically, it's just going out to eat,
yep,
bringing your family in, and then you can do all this other
stuff
with it.
If I didn't tell you it was healthy, most people don't know.
That's true.
Let
me ask you a question. If I'm walking in and you look at my son, how do you know what he's going to need to eat to help him make his goals?
It's to get ultra technical with it, I don't. We can sit down and it just based off of looks, it's impossible to tell because everybody's needs are different.
Yep.
There is no one shoe, nutritionally speaking, that's going to fill everybody's needs, which is why we have different sizes of meals, different amounts of protein, different amount of carbs, fats that goes into meals. We do regular meals, we do Whole30, we do paleo, we do keto. There really isn't a niche that we can do. The biggest thing is to eat clean.
Okay.
Eat food as close to the source as possible, that's minimally processed, you're off to a good start, and then we can fill in what you need and make a plan that's perfect for you.
That's awesome. Okay, so you guys have had a really great success story right now, but you guys have something even bigger coming up. And let's talk about the downtown why and
downtown,
what's going on. Look at the smile on your face.
Absolutely.
That's a small town business owner smile right there. Almost there? Okay. All right, I'm right. We'll come back. So we're going to hit this next one. We'll talk about the downtown why.
Perfect.
And then we'll talk about wrestling.
Moms typically get to make a majority of the healthcare decisions for their family. That can be a lot of pressure, but not for me, because I know the choice is ours. For medical tests like MRIs, x-rays, CAT scans, and of course mammograms, ask your doctor to refer you to Iowa Radiology. They work around our hectic schedules, they're the best at what they do, and they're so great with my family. They truly care, and it shows. Visit iowaradiology.com or call to schedule an appointment. Iowa Radiology, our focus is your good health.
Miss your hometown clothing store, the one that had it all, everything to get the work done all in one place? G&L Clothing is your hometown Iowa store. Stop in and see us, or we're only a click or phone call away. Family owned for nearly a century, G&L Clothing, 1801 Ingersoll, Des Moines.
G&L Clothing, your size, your style. All right, so we're back. Before break, we were talking about you guys going down to the downtown Y.
Yes.
And you were smiling because that is a huge success for you guys. Tell us a little bit about that real quick.
Okay. If you take care of people and you're good with people and you believe in people's best interests, good things will happen to you. We have an opportunity. It just started under construction. It's been announced a little bit. Our new location, we are building inside the Wellmark YMCA downtown. Skywalk access, everybody downtown. There's not going to be a reason why anybody who works downtown or lives downtown can't eat healthy, quick, and affordable. New name as well, too, for downtown. I don't know how many people know this. It's actually, we're going to call it Fueled Cafe.
Okay.
Cafe. People, be a little easier for people to find us and know they're getting healthy fuel for their body.
All right, before we switch gears, give us your address real quick and tell us a little bit where you can get your food at.
Perfect.
And we'll move on.
Prep meals you can order online. You have until Friday, 4 p.m. to pick up on Sunday. That's beefcakefuel.com. Make sure you get the fuel on there. It really helps to get to the right address. Our restaurant location is at 2800 University Avenue in Clock Tower Square.
Okay.
Clock Tower Square, it's right there in University, just down the hill from Valley West Mall.
And soon,
and just down the hill from you. Yeah, absolutely.
All right, before we wrap this up, you guys are on a mission, and I love this because you guys are helping girls' sports here in Iowa.
Yes.
And we're going to talk about wrestling because I know the girls' state wrestling tournament is going on, but you guys have some advocating that you guys have been doing.
We do. So we're blessed with two beautiful daughters. Their athletic is my wife and I combined. Our oldest daughter is a freshman at Waukee. She's wrestling again this year. She spent a little bit of time on the varsity mat for Waukee.
Yes.
And on the 19th of this month is the girls state wrestling meet. A little bit of political issues going on. It's not a certified sanctioned sport in Iowa yet, which is what we're advocating for. To give every girl across the state who wants to wrestle an opportunity to wrestle and to take their careers farther and help with their education as well, too.
That's perfect. So let me ask you a question. I know you have the daughters in it, but why wrestling? What is in your heart that you love wrestling?
It's purity. Yep. You know, from a competitive standpoint, two people walk onto a mat. It's one-on-one. You either put in the time or you didn't. You either are better at the technique or you're not. You can't make excuses. It's the purest form of sports that I ever competed in, and I believe it's one of the purest form of sports that exists.
Okay. Well, Brad, I want to thank you, number one, for coming out. We do want to give you another shout-out for being an Iowa-based company.
You.
That's impressive. I know how it is being an Iowa-based company myself. We're excited to, you know, with your guys' venture downtown at the Wellmark YMCA. What's the name of that again?
It's going to be Fueled Cafe.
Fueled Cafe. So I just want to say congratulations on that.
Thank you.
I'll stop over and get a meal from you.
Awesome.
Make sure you guys stop out and see him. We want to thank Brad for being on the TST 20 Tip of the Week. I also want to give out a shout-out to Vision Park Family Care for these great classes. But also, guys, we are fighting an epidemic here in Iowa. We're trying to get Iowa active and eating healthy. Stop down and see Brad Rodish.
Yep.
I'm going to say this right. At Beefcake.
Beefcake Fuel.
All right. Yep. We want to thank you guys again. Up next on CISN TV is going to be Dar Danielson with an interview with Maryland's head basketball coach. All right. We want to thank you guys one more time. We'll see you guys soon.
Thank you.
Moms typically get to make a majority of the healthcare decisions for their family. That can be a lot of pressure, but not for me, because I know the choice is ours. From medical tests like MRIs, x-rays, CAT scans, and of course mammograms, ask your doctor to refer you to Iowa Radiology. They work around our hectic schedules, they're the best at what they do, and they're so great with my family. They truly care, and it shows. Visit iowaradiology.com or call to schedule an appointment. Iowa Radiology, our focus is your good health.
Hi, Ron here, head coach of Westside Auto Pros. When your car's on the injured reserve, you want to get it back in the game as soon as possible. I know that. That's why you need to bring it here to Westside Auto Pros. I have a team of experts that can fix almost every automotive injury, whether it's a fractured joint, a brake, or if your car just got its bell rung, no problem. We can even do a complete physical on your car to make sure it's game ready for the entire season. So bring your car to Westside Auto Pros and we'll get it back in the starting lineup in no time. Hey, you guys are dogging it back here. Let's move it, move it, move it.
American Energy and you, together partnering to change the energy landscape by pioneering money-saving, energy efficiency programs and building a new industry in Iowa, wind energy, all while keeping your rates low. So what's next? We'll keep delivering cost-effective energy efficiency programs while putting money back in your pocket. That's right, you decide how best to spend your savings. That's a partnership good for you, good for the environment, and good for Iowa. Another way we're obsessively, relentlessly at your service.
We're at Thunderhead Sports Bar and Grill in Ankeny on Ore Labor. I'm Jimmy Olsen at CISN.TV. And this week we've been having a great show for you, and there's still a lot of great stuff to come for you. In fact, right now, just a few weeks ago, Dar Danielson had a kind of like impromptu interview that he was not expecting. We were actually doing a game, and Brenda Freese just kind of like showed up out of nowhere from Cedar Rapids, closing on, went to University of Arizona, closing on her 500th victory with the Maryland, being the Maryland head women's basketball coach. So let's check out the interview with Brenda and Dar.
Brenda Freese is joining us, the head coach of Maryland basketball, and an Iowa native, right?
Absolutely, Cedar Rapids.
Cedar Rapids, and I watched you at Iowa State under Bill Family, right?
Yes,
that was,
yes,
what, 4 years ago you played there, right?
Yeah, just like four years ago, something like that. I'm going into year 17 at Maryland.
Has it been that many? Wow, that's a long time. But, you know, and built a good program there in the Big Ten, and you managed to come back here and keep an eye on the Iowa girls and get one of them now and then.
Absolutely.
Huh?
We know where all that great talent lies, and obviously we're extremely excited about signing Zoe Young, and I think she just has a tremendous, bright career ahead of her for us at Maryland, and we're excited about, I am, the opportunity to coach her for the next 4 years and beyond.
Now you're here watching her, and as you go to games, you kind of watch all the other. Is there anybody that, you know, with today, with all the film and stuff that goes around, is there anybody that ever comes out that's a sleeper that maybe shows up that you hadn't, wasn't on your recruiting radar?
You know, back in the day, yes. Nowadays, you haven't done your homework if you know, between the internet and, you know, as many games as that we get to evaluate and how the structure is set up. So it is a lot more difficult, I have to say, nowadays compared to what it was like back in the past. Before pre-internet.
Yeah, so now everybody's kind of a known quantity, the ones that want to go play basketball. There's a lot more, I think, a lot more opportunities now for girls in Iowa and overall now, especially with, you know, you got soccer, volleyball. It seems like more are going on to play college there than what they used to be. It's come a long way, hasn't it?
Yeah, it really has. I mean, compared to the days back when I grew up, I mean, so many opportunities, and it's exciting to see young girls growing up and achieving dreams in any sport that they are fulfilled in. And, you know, it's exciting to be able to see that next opportunity to go on to college and beyond.
A lot of times we look at, you know, we see the scoring, and if a player scores a lot, we think, well, that's a great player, might be college. But what do you look for beyond that, and you know, their ability to score? What kind of things make a good Division I basketball?
That winning mentality, right? I mean, that passion. I mean, when we play 30-plus games in a season, you got to love being in the gym. You need to be an awesome teammate. I love kids that are, they're fluid. They can play a lot of positions. They can do a variety of things. And but that championship mentality is a big thing for us.
I got to admit, I haven't followed the college game as much. I've been focused on high school. I do know that Iowa's had the ranked teams. Was it Drake, Iowa State, and Iowa ranked? Iowa took it on the chin a little bit against the number one Notre Dame. But the Big Ten, how do you see that this year?
It's going to be so competitive. When you look at, Iowa being ranked, Minnesota had a great win last night against Syracuse. We're 7-0. We're ranked 7th in the country. So, the battles in the Big Ten, you're going to see every night. Michigan State had a 30-point win in the Big Ten ACC Challenge. So, every night you have to show up and be ready to play.
Now, is there something when you come back to Iowa that you can't get in Maryland that you like to stop off and get or have a treat or something?
I love to visit family first and foremost, and being able to come back. But you got to love the meat, right? Steak and, no better place to be able to find some steak.
Yeah. Well, it's good that we appreciate taking a little time out here as you're watching some of these players here tonight. And hey, don't take too many out of Iowa. Leave some for the other teams here.
There's plenty to go around. But we'll take our Zoe. We're excited to have her.
And that's another thing, too. There's a lot more girls that seem they play more on the club teams and the other stuff. And there's a lot more that seem like they're signing and going to other places, too, aren't they?
Yeah, I mean, that's it's exciting. Hopefully we're getting more parity in our game and, the opportunity to go to so many different places and, just have some, tremendous opportunities.
Okay, well, Brenda Fries, we appreciate you taking a little time out to talk with us. She's the head coach of Maryland here, an Iowa native. We're going to take a break. We'll come back, get ready for the start of the second half after this on CISN.TV.
At Thunderhead Sports Bar and Grill in Ankeny on Orlabor, I'm Jimmy Olsen at CISN.TV this week, and we're going to go over the boys and girls rankings with Flynn Heal. That's coming up next on CISN.TV.
American Energy and you, together partnering to change the energy landscape by pioneering money-saving, energy efficiency programs and building a new industry in Iowa, wind energy, all while keeping your rates low. So what's next? We'll keep delivering cost-effective energy efficiency programs while putting money back in your pocket. That's right. You decide how best to spend your savings. That's a partnership good for you, good for the environment, and good for Iowa. Another way we're obsessively, relentlessly at your service.
Moms typically get to make a majority of the healthcare decisions for their family. That can be a lot of pressure, but not for me, because I know the choice is ours. From medical tests like MRIs, x-rays, CAT scans, and of course mammograms, ask your doctor to refer you to Iowa Radiology. They work around our hectic schedules, they're the best at what they do, and they're so great with my family. They truly care, and it shows. Visit iowaradiology.com or call to schedule an appointment. Iowa Radiology, our focus is your good health.
Miss your hometown clothing store? The one that had it all? Everything to get the work done all in one place? G&L Clothing is your hometown Iowa store. Stop in and see us. Or we're only a click or phone call away. Family owned for nearly a century. G&L Clothing. 1801 Ingersoll, Des Moines.
G&L Clothing. Your size, your style, we've got it all.
Want to get stronger, faster, healthier? You want more. You want to be part of something bigger than yourself. A place for people of all ages, all walks of life, that provides opportunities for all to succeed. We do that. We're the why. Build more than muscle. Build a stronger community.
At Thunderhead Sports Bar and Grill in Ankeny on Orlabor, I'm Jimmy Olsen. It's this week on CISN.TV with Flynn Heald right now. And we're going to go over the rankings. And now, of course, the girls, again, are going to be coming out tomorrow, which there's been a couple losses.
Yep.
So I'm sure there's going to be some changes. But this is where, as of what we looked at earlier, again, these are going to be changing tomorrow. Number 10, we've got Pleasant Valley, Dowling, of course, at number 9, Cedar Rapids, Prairie at 8, Cedar Rapids, Washington at 7, West Des Moines Valley at 6, Waukee at number 5, Southeast Polk at 4, and Cedar Falls at 3, Johnson 2, Iowa City. They're in first place. But again, these are going to be coming out again tomorrow, so you're going to see some changes.
Yeah, you will see some changes. And looking through the rankings again, at number 9, you've got Dowling at 4-4 right here. They're led by Caitlin Clark. She's a phenomenal player. There's 5 teams total from the CIML located in the rankings. You got led by Johnston with 9-1. I just heard that they lost, as well as Cedar Falls. So Southeast Polk's now sitting at 10-1. You can assume they'll be moving up those rankings. And we just heard from Tracy as well. So
that's great having her here, because yep. She was able to feed us a lot of information, you know, to just make us sound a little better than, you know.
She was our insider.
That's right. That we got some insider information, which, again, don't forget, girls are going to be, you'll be able to see those games this Friday night right here on CISN.TV and Fast Southeast Polk. Boys and girls at Valley, you're going to be able to see that here. And then Centennial at Ankeny Friday night, again, boys and girls. So you'll see both of those games here on CISN.TV. Now we'll roll over into the boys and look at how the standings are for them. That's going to start off at number 10 with the Dubuque Senior. Valley, West Des Moines Valley, they're at number 9. Ames at 8. Cedar Falls at 7. Sioux City at 6. Then into the top 5 with Iowa City at number 5. Bettendorf at number 4. Davenport Central at 3. Waukee at 2. And North Scott sitting in first place.
We got 3 teams representing the area on boys basketball. Some great teams. You got Valley at 9. Number 9 at 9-2. Ames is 8-1 at 8, and Waukee 8-0. There's a lot of good basketball players in the area. If you have not been going to the games, go ahead and check some of those out.
Absolutely, and of course, a lot of those games you can check right here on CISN.TV. So again, just to go over those again, this Friday night, we're going to have that basketball action for you. Centennial at Ankeny, boys and girls, and then Southeast Polk at Valley, boys and girls. If you're just finding us, you haven't subscribed to us yet, be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel so you can catch out our weekly show, as well as all the games and wrestling that we do throughout the year on CISN.TV. From Thunderhead Sports Bar and Grill on Oral Labor in Ankeny, we're going to be back again here next week. If you want to be here and be part of the show, it all gets underway at 6 o'clock, so you can be here to see that. Don't forget, play of the week, video of the week. If you got a play of the week that you want to share with us, you want to do that on Twitter and on Facebook. Share that with us, and you could end up seeing your play of the week right here on CISN.TV. So for the crew tonight, for Flynn Heald, I'm Jimmy Olson at Thunderhead Sports Bar and Grill in Ankeny. It's this week on CISN.TV.